Welcome back. Great to have your company on this Tuesday morning. Now, it is the age-old dilemma, whether to scrimp and save and enrol your child in a private school or stick with a public system. Many people think it is worth the extra money, but new research shows that in the last 5 years, there's been a resurgence in parents sending their kids to public schools. Statistics show that 65% of Australian kids are enrolled in a public school and 35% attend a private school. So, should we send our children to the state school down the road, or do you make that financial sacrifice? Do you send them to a private school in the hope of better academic success? For today's agenda, I'm joined by social researcher Mark McCrindle and Jodie Allen from Stay at Home Mum. Good morning to you both.
Good morning.
Jodie, if I can start with you, you've had the experience where you've had your kids in a private school and you've pulled them out.
I have.
Why?
A lot of reasons, really. There is cost, of course. You know, private schools are very expensive, and with that money I can afford to send them to, you know, karate lessons and swimming lessons and things like that. But also the curriculum has been a lot better. They're things like that are much more strategic.
In the public system?
Absolutely, in the public system. And my children have thrived in public as opposed to private.
Because that sort of is counter to a lot of people would think, because I know that in the private system, class sizes tend to be a bit smaller than in many of the state schools. In terms of the other differences, what have you noticed between the both that you've had with your own personal experience?
Oh, of course, you have the class sizes. I found in the public schools, got more fields to run around, which is really great for boys. The teachers are more accountable, which I really like. They, you know, they're up with all the latest and greatest on every topic. They just tend to be more knowledgeable on things like autism spectrum and things like that, which affects me. And it's just been just really great for my children.
Wow, it's an interesting one. And Mark, in terms of your perspective, the research is quite surprising in terms of the number of people making that choice, doing what Jodie's doing.
Yeah, particularly of recent times. So over the last 30 years, public schools have grown by less than private schools. The growth has been in private. But in the last 5 years, that's flipped. And it's the public system that's added three times as many students as the private system. And that last 5 years, of course, has coincided with rising house prices, cost of living pressures. And so a lot of families with their budgets under strain are saying, well, maybe we can save a bit by sending the children up the road at the local public school. Mm. And so that, along with population growth, is why we've seen recently the public school enrolments grow faster than privates.
And we have seen, I mean, there are obviously tiers in the private sector in terms of the expense that a lot of parents are making the choice to send their children to cheaper private schools. Is that simply because people just don't have the budget?
Exactly. And if we look at the private system, it's the Catholic sector and particularly the independent schools, those lower fee schools, where we've seen the growth. So a lot of people think private schools, it's $30,000 a year. There's a lot of $2,000 a year schools, $3,000 a year for independent schools. And that's where the growth has been as parents look for an alternative, but of course don't have that spare amount of money that we traditionally think of as private schools.
Every experience is obviously individual, and we've asked our viewers for their feedback. Robbie has said, I'd love to be able to afford to send my daughter to private school. She's stuck in a public school where most of the year four students are at a year two level. Carmen says, we're changing to public. My children have autism and didn't receive the care they needed. Similar experience to you, Jodie. And Ariane says, not if the public school around the corner is a fantastic one. I wish we didn't have the private public system. I suppose, Jodie, though, when you see the resources, if you go into a private school, you see the gymnasiums, you see the music resources, you see the tuition available, the swimming pools, you look at all of that and think, they are going to have the edge over schools, students from the public school system.
Yeah, a fancy swimming pool isn't going to matter by the time they finish school, though. The academic is where it's all at. And, as you know, it's proven that the public schools are doing better than the private schools. And plus, with the demographic of public schools, they're going to be exposed to all people, which is great, because that's how it is when they're going to be out in the workforce rather than have that very sheltered experience. Mm. So, you know, you've got to give them a little bit of struggle muscle.
You think? Mm-hmm. Worth doing. So is it being reflected academically, Mark? Are we seeing that there just simply isn't the result coming from the outlay?
Yeah, if it's purely a parent's focus is academic performance, well, the selective schools are in the public sector. Mm. And if you look at the leagues tables, as they're called, the top performing schools in the HSC or any Year 12 exams, you do see about 9 out of the top 10 are public schools.
But they're a different kettle of fish, though. They're the selective system where they're the best of the best.
And so it does depend on what parents are looking for. Most parents choosing private education, looking for a broader experience beyond just the academics, co-curricular and other things, and those facilities will help provide that. Mm. But also, as you mentioned, the smaller class size in the private system does assist some. But if it's purely, you know, top of the range academics, those selective schools, which are the public ones, are still the go-to places.
And what sort of cost are we talking? What were you outlaying, Jodie, when you had your kids in private?
We were one of the sort of lower-cost Catholic schools, which was great, sort of about $5,000 a year. So it was, you know, wasn't like the $30,000 a year. It was still relatively affordable, but still what I can do with that $5,000 for my boys now and how much they're enjoying all those extra things, I think the money was worth it for me.
So what would you say to a parent who is grappling with, you know, obviously it's a luxury if you have that choice to begin with. A lot of people do scrimp and save in able to consider that private school system. But if a parent's wondering about what to do, weighing up the pros and cons, what would you say to them?
Oh, have a look at the school. Schools are as individual as kids. Wherever they're going to go, which makes your child happy and thrive, then that's the right school for you.
And market is a personal thing too. Obviously, every child is different. So I suppose you've got to tailor the child to the school.
Yeah, exactly. And work out from a parent and family perspective, what is your focus? What is the priority? You know, and again, those broader curricular activities for some, that's what they want. You know, the values or character or leadership development or whatever, you know, there's more of a focus of that in the independent sector, the academics, as we said, or that diversity of student experience, the public sector. So it depends on parents' own values and what they're looking for.
Yeah, a lot to weigh up. Good to have you in and to talk about this topic. Thank you, Jodie, and thank you, Mark.
Thank you.
Carl.
Thank you, Deb.